Museums across the country are finally reopening. One brand new exhibition that awaits visitors is Treasures of Korea, showcasing the latest artifacts recognized as national treasures. Kim Do-yeon takes us to the National Museum of Korea.
Portraits from the Joseon Dynasty, artwork depicting the livelihoods of those who lived centuries ago, ceramics from the 10th century, and even famous calligraphy. These such items can all be seen in Seoul.
Just as public museums reopen across the country, the National Museum of Korea is holding an exhibition of cultural artifacts recently added to the list of treasures and national treasures. It's the biggest exhibition of its kind.
From 2017 to 2019, the Cultural Heritage Administration of Korea added 157 sets of items to the list. Here, there are 83 sets, totally 196 individual items that are on display.
National treasures recognized by the Cultural Heritage Administration best represent the brilliance of Korea's history and culture. When a tangible item from history proves its worth in research, arts, and rarity, experts investigate and deem it to be a treasure. If it is known to be one of the first of its kind and has value on humanity, we promote it as a national treasure.
The exhibition is divided into three different sections. The first is called Documenting History. Here, items such as a recently discovered edition of Joseon Wangjo Shilluk or the annals from Joseon Dynasty are displayed. The second section is called Flourishing Art, where artworks and calligraphy are on display, including work by one of Korea's most beloved historical artists, Kim Hong-do. The last section is called Embodying Wishes, displaying items related to Buddhism, including this book by King Sejong, Worin Cheonggangjigok, or Songs of the Moon's Reflection on a Thousand Rivers. Running until September 27th, the museum also said that due to COVID-19, each two-hour session will allow 200 people in at a time with body temperature screening and visitors being asked to refrain from talking. Kim Do-yeon, Arirang News.